In this video, we will cover how to convert infinitely repeating decimals to fractions. Let's say we have the infinitely repeating decimal 0.22222, where the 2's repeat on forever. How would we go about converting this to a fraction? To start, let's say this value is equal to x. If we multiply this equation by 10 on both sides, what we get is 10x is equal to 2.22222, and so on. Let's call this equation on the top A, and this equation on the bottom B. Now, if we subtract equation A from equation B, in other words, if we do B minus A, what we're left with on the left side is 10x minus x, and on the right side we have 2.222, where the 2's repeat, minus 0.222, where the 2's repeat as well. The left side becomes 9x, and the right side just becomes 2, because the repeating 2's after the decimal point cancel. If we divide by 9 on both sides, we get x is equal to 2/9. And this fraction, 2 over 9, is 0.2222, where the 2's repeat on forever, expressed as a fraction. In order to verify that we have done this conversion correctly, let's use a calculator. So we plug in 2 over 9, and we should get 0.2222. And when we perform this division, that's exactly what we get. So we know that we have converted this infinitely repeating decimal to a fraction successfully. Now let's try a variation of this problem. Let's say we have to convert the infinitely repeating decimal quantity 0.234234. And so on to a fraction. If we try to use the same technique as in the last problem and multiply both sides of the equation by 10, we get 10x is equal to 2.34234, and so on. If we call this equation A and this one B, now if we subtract A from B, on the left side we have 9x. On the right side, you'll notice that the infinitely repeating numbers after the decimal point don't cancel because they don't match up. So on the right side, we're left with some quantity that's not nice to work with. So we know that multiplying by 10 on both sides won't work in this scenario. So let's take a slightly different approach. Notice that the recurring group of numbers after the decimal point is of length 3. So if we multiply equation A by 1,000 on both sides, on the left-hand side we have 1,000x, and on the right-hand side, the decimal place moves 3 spaces to the right, and we have 234.234234, where this pattern continues on forever. Let's call this equation C, and you'll notice if we subtract A from C, that is if we do C minus A, on the left-hand side, we have 1,000x minus x, which is going to be 999x, and on the right side, we are left with just 234. Because the numbers after the decimal point in both equations match up, and thus they cancel out when we do the subtraction. Dividing by 999 on both sides gives us x is equal to 234 divided by 999. Now, just like with the last problem, let's use a calculator to verify that we have done this conversion successfully. If we plug in 234 divided by 999, we should get 0.234234, and so on. And when we perform the division, we do. So we know we have performed the conversion successfully.